What's up, YouTube? As you can see, it happened. Being closed is now at the house. It has been purchased. It's a done deal. And man, am I happy about it. So it's got an RV style door on the outside instead of the bar style. So that way it's easier for me and my daughter to get in and out of. And then it's got the actual bar style on the back. This one's not like a toy hauler. It doesn't have the tailgate. It's just double swinging. It's a 6x12. I didn't think that door was gonna stay open. But it's a 6x12, and as you can see, probably hard to show in the video, but the back of it is not that high up off the ground. Loading the bikes and stuff in it are not gonna be any problem whatsoever. Everything in it right now is what it came with. Spare tire holder, a little light, and that's about it. The rest of it's just brochure stuff that can get yanked off. It's got 4 tie downs on the floor and 4 rings on the wall. Little tiny thin plywood veneer over 3/8 plywood for the walls. I'm not sure yet what kind of insulation I'm gonna do. But it's definitely going to end up being insulated. I'm not sure when I'll start that project, but I'm probably going to have a small bench up here in the front, be able to store stuff under it, the camping stuff, sleeping bags, air mattresses, whatever, small bench to cook on. And then when we pull the bikes out, then we'll have our beds here. I think we're just going to do inflatable mattresses for me and my daughter. Plenty of room for them. The width of the trailer on the inside is actually only, I think it's 5'8" from one wall to another. Well, me being 6'2", I can't actually turn the bed sideways, which is not a super huge deal, but I was hoping there'd be enough room that we could do them sideways in here, but we can't. So it's gonna end up being lengthwise, but no big deal. Lots of projects in the future to come on this one. The insulation of it, gonna make the table, get the camping gear all stowed in here, up on the tongue. I want to do a 2 or 3 fuel can cargo rack up here, so it'll hold 2 or 3 fuel cans with lockable bar that will go through them all and lock them to it. That way they're outside of the living space of the trailer and they're not inside the Jeep, because fuel cans inside where you breathe is never a great thing. So I want to get that done at some point. For my daughter, we're going to do chalkboard paint. We're gonna paint the interior with some chalkboard paint, and then she'll be able to come in here with her chalk and just draw whatever she wants, decorate it up, do a whole village of motorcycles playing on the dunes, whatever she wants to draw on there. And then probably on the outside, I don't know, maybe we'll choose one door or one side, or maybe just all over. I've got thousands of stickers, decals, stickers that have came from parts or from bikes. Just tons of stickers from all sorts of different stuff. So we're probably gonna sticker bomb the hell out of it. So pretty nice trailer. It's not the most expensive trailer. It's not the best made trailer. One of the things that made this one cheaper than others is that the seams are all 24 inch on center. So from one rib of webbing to the next, the framing, whatever you wanna call it, is 24 inch from one to the next. Well, that does two things. One, it makes the walls a little bit more flimsy, or not flimsy, but it's less structurally sound, but it makes the trailer lighter. And since I'm towing this behind my Jeep, I wanted the lighter. So that is what it is. And then the other thing is just the thickness of the plywood and stuff on the wall, the tiny little veneer. I mean, probably hard to show you, but it's super thin. So Not the greatest stuff, not the greatest hardware. All this stuff, of course, could be upgraded. Get some E-Track put in here for more attachment points and everything. There's an awful lot of diamond plate used on this trailer. I don't know what that little strip there is for. Just a kickboard, I guess. But the fender flares are the aluminum diamond plate. And then the rock guard. And they even put some on the frame. So there's a lot of chrome diamond plate. I'm not really a chrome guy, but there's a lot of it. So, pretty nice trailer if you ask me. Pretty good setup. Got it all done in one day. really nice group of guys to work with to get it and everything. So plenty happy. Hold on and wait for the next update. We'll be doing insulation or working on a bench or something for it, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Later.